Hey everybody, I'm Brendan72Mo. This is the Willard Faction, and I'm about to find out if it'll off-road. If you notice a sense of trepidation in my voice, that's because this car is broken. And I'm not talking about the recent physics bug that actually got fixed on, yesterday when you're watching this. Yes, the physics bug was fixed. But no, the Willard Faction has always been broken. Since it's been out, Rockstar's never bothered to fix it. Because I'm sure in their eyes, the solution is to pay to upgrade it into either a classic or into a donk, if you have no taste. I would upgrade it to a classic, but then it would lose its ride height and it would stance the wheels. And I've gone for a Buick Grand National inspired theme that would be ruined with this thing as a lowrider. So, if you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll try to remember to put some footage in of it. I showed it off in a recent live stream. Of how this car, when it hits a curb, it just goes flying into the air. It's broken. There's just something busted about this car. I don't really know what. I don't think anybody's ever really gotten down to the bottom of what's wrong with it. But something about its physics and its geometry is just wrong. So, I'm expecting this to be pretty disastrous, but so far, it's actually doing all right. In places that I would have expected it to go flipping off the road, landing on its roof, it's doing okay. If you're wondering why it struggled a little bit, though, for power, it's because it doesn't have the engine upgrade. Since this car is broken, I mean, you can see I never even bothered to put a custom license plate on this thing. Love the looks of the car, but I never drive it, except for the lols now and then. Just because it's broken. It sits in my garage to be pretty. That's the only reason I have it. But because of that, I never put performance upgrades on it. But then when it got 44 votes for Will It Off-Road, I realized I needed to do something to it. I was going to just put armor on it so that it wouldn't explode when we did the damage descent. But then I decided I wanted brakes for the controlled descent. So it does have fully upgraded brakes. And the turbo and transmission were on sale, so I went ahead and put the turbo and transmission on it. And I also put sport suspension on it, just so it would have better turning radius. And, yeah, I should have just went ahead and spent the 50 grand for an engine, but, you know, I was being cheap. So that's why it struggled a little bit for power, but otherwise it's surprisingly doing well. And speaking of 44 votes, I'm pretty sure I kind of like doomed myself to it by driving it in the live stream the other day because somebody made a comment, wouldn't it be hilarious to see Brandon take that off-roading? Well, so far it's actually proven to be really competent up here on the mountain. I am blown away by this. This thing is going over these bumps. Yeah, it's behaving weird, unlike any other car in the game, but it's not flipping itself over on it like it does on the curbs when you're on city streets. It's just bizarre that it's handling this well. But it did get 44 votes, and you can vote for the vehicles that you want to see in Will It Off-Road by clicking on the link in the description down below. Vote for any car you want. There's a big long list of cars that I currently own. But if there's a vehicle in the game that you want to see tested for Will It Off-Road, well then, you can write it in. At the very bottom, there's an other option. There's currently some people trying to get the AirTug as one of the cars that I test for Will It Off-Road, but they've only managed to vote 6 times. You can vote as often as you want. The Google form will allow you to vote over and over again. Backing up here for what may be a suicide because of the way this car jumps around, but it couldn't get up the hill. It bucked a little bit there, but we're up. This has been an absolute surprise. We're up to the top of Mount Chiliad. 3 minutes, almost 57 seconds. Will it off-road? Yes. What the fuck? Yes, this car did great off-road. I am utterly, utterly amazed. Speechless almost, but of course, you know, I have to keep talking because the video's got another 15 minutes left in it. So we begin the controlled descent. And this is, once I did the uphill run, my worry then shifted over to, well, uphill, gravity kind of pulls it back down, and Yeah, that's already a bit of a harbinger there. That worried me when it did that little roll. I just became really concerned that on these uneven bumps that it would send me flying off the side of the mountain because of, well, now I'm going downhill and gravity wants to pull me on down. There is going to be one minor mishap here in just a minute. Spoilers. Right there. I couldn't get enough speed shaved back off of it from where it had gone over and jumped when I didn't really want the car to jump. A lot of cars don't jump at this point that this one did. But the faction decided they wanted to jump. Had too much speed. Couldn't navigate that little chicane, I guess you'd call it. And it went over the side. But, again, it didn't flip and roll down the side of the mountain. It just kind of hopped over. So, you know, as far as mishaps go, it's a good one. Or, I guess, the best outcome you can hope for, at least. Problem is, I'm trying to get it back up the side of the mountain. It's going to make it, but this is risky because it drops right back off the other side. I got to be quick. Oh, I was really afraid that it was going to jump there. And you can see it kind of kicked up a little bit on me, but I got lucky, or else I'm a really good driver. This whole run has either been just pure luck, or I am actually really competent at off-roading. It's one of the two. Maybe a combination of both. Coming around the bend that leads to some really uneven terrain, most cars, yeah, you can see the right-hand side didn't even want to dip down. It's like it wasn't even there. This car behaves so weird. But I love the looks of it. It is a beautiful car. I love Buick Grand Nationals from the 80s. Fantastic, fantastic car. So, of course, in this game, this is a V8 turbo, and Grand Nationals had a V6 turbo. But for the longest time, it was one of the unbeatable cars, the Grand National was. I mean, it took it to supercars. You know, just a Buick, which is hard to imagine today. But the controlled descent, other than that slight rollover at the very top and then hopping off the side of the path, controlled descent has been fine. I mean, it handled that big jump really well. It's handling all these bumps in the road really well. Who knew? Who knew that a car that is so worthless on city streets would actually perform well in an off-road condition? I mean, it's not been a particularly fast run by any stretch of the imagination, but it's done it. It has completed it. It hasn't been a struggle. I haven't even really been fighting with this car all that much. It does want to spin out every once in a while, but it's a muscle car. That's kind of to be expected. They have shit brakes. There, it kind of kicked up. That's the behavior I was expecting the whole run. And then here it happened just towards the end. Thankfully, there are no curbs to cause problems now that we are down on asphalt. We're coming around to the finish. Commander Hobo tying up traffic just over there to the right. We're down 3 minutes 44 seconds, which means taking it back to the top of Mount Chiliad and seeing how much damage it could take. Of course, like I said, I did put 100% armor on this car, so it wouldn't blow up. But I like it. I don't want it to blow up. And already we're into some trouble here. It doesn't want to get traction to get off these rocks, so I decide instead, I'll just back over. By the way, right after I did this run, this damage descent, I drove it over to Polito Bay and pulled it into Beakers, got it fixed, and then tested it. Is it still broken over curbs? And yes, it was still broken on curbs at the time of this recording. It went flipping and flying up into the air just like normal when you hit just a tiny little bump on the asphalt. So why it handles so well off-road, I don't know. I really do not understand how it does so well off-road, but can't handle something like a small bit of concrete. It makes no sense whatsoever. This car is taking one hell of a beating, though. I mean, there's been a model for this car in the game since the game launched. If you go to some of the junkyard areas where there's rusted out cars, I know there's one in Sandy Shores, and I think there's one down in the, I can't think of the name of the area, but where the oil wells are, and several other places where you see rusted out cars, you'll see a rusted out just shell of one of these sitting there. So the car's been in the game for a while. So it actually has damage to fix. So it is physically taking damage. It's kind of hard to see, but the front end is beat to hell. We'll get a better look at that here in just a few seconds once we do the little spinning around shot. Even on this really rough stuff here, I'm just blown away. I expected this car to flip and bounce and roll nonstop, but it went through that muddy, bumpy terrain without issue. Of course, it can't get up the side of this hill, but that's all right. There we go, it's up. Just an unreal performance from this car. And it is down for the damage it sent, 2 minutes, 16 seconds. And let's take a look at how much damage it did sustain. Most of the lights and windows are gone. The front bumper, fenders, and hood are gone. The doors in the trunk won't close. It has very significant body damage and bent wheels. But that brings us to our next car, the ProGen T20. The T20 comes in with 106 votes. So don't forget, you can vote for the vehicles that you want to see by clicking on the link in the description down below. And excuse me as I take a drink of water. So, once again, a bit of disclosure. Nothing about the performance upgrades. This car is fully upgraded. However, the bulk of the votes for the T20 actually specified a red T20. Well, I don't have a red T20. Mine's brown. Actually, kind of a very beautiful brown, if you ask me. But, more of a bronze brown. I'm pretty sure I know who it is that owns a red T20 that was wanting to see their own car tested. So I just have to point out something. I updated the Will It Off-Road voting form. If I own a car in GTA Online, I will test my own car. Because that way I can say for sure this has all the upgrades. It's missing a certain upgrade like we just did with the faction. Plus, I don't have to worry about scheduling problems. I can just get on and record these when it's convenient for me, and it may not always be convenient for somebody else. But the Will It Off-Road is not a video series for you to showcase your own cars. If you play on PC and you want to see your own cars featured on my channel, well, have at least one 10-car garage full of beautiful cars, contact me and we can see about doing a garage tour. So the T20 is not my favorite supercar in the game. I love the looks of it. I love the sound of it. I like its interior. I think it's a great car. I just don't like the way it drives. Honestly, I preferred the way it drives on old gen. Because it does, even though it has an animated spoiler on old gen, you don't get the traction boost from it. And I really prefer the way the T20 drives on old gen. I don't like the changing dynamic of its handling when you are at different speeds. I guess that's the reason I don't like it. I've never really been able to really pinpoint exactly what it is about the T20 that I dislike. But it's just not my car for racing. It's not my car for driving. It sits in my garage most of the time. I don't get rid of it because, again, beautiful car. And I love having it in my collection. I do take it for a spin now and then, but meh. Just not my type of car. And of course, as you'll see here in a few minutes, it kind of earns a little bit more contempt from me. But for this uphill run, it's been pretty uneventful. It is rather lightweight, so it gets air like we just saw in a lot of unexpected places, but it's turning in a fantastic time. Of course, that all-wheel drive layout really does help it in the dirt. Making its final climb up, and we are up to the top of Mount Chiliad. 2 minutes, 45 seconds with two hikers down. Will it off-road? Yes, of course it will. No surprises there. A lot of the supercars will, especially the all-wheel drive ones. But it turned in a fantastic time, despite the fact that I don't have a lot of love for the car. Well, the way it handles. It's the way it drives. Love it look. Love the looks. Love the sound. Love the idea behind it. Just don't like the way it drives. So we're doing our controlled descent, and I don't really expect any surprises here either. The T20 is a fairly planted car. It doesn't bounce around a lot. And it does have good brakes. Actually, it has exceptional brakes. It has decent amounts of traction, so it'll do fine. But as we just saw right there, as I took another drink of water, it is an incredibly lightweight car. So it is going to be more prone to jump up in the air than a heavier car would be. Which can be a liability if you're not careful when you're coming down the mountain. If you know the car is going to do it, well then, it probably won't catch you off guard. And if you've run this path as many times as I have, I mean, this is Willett Off-Road number 44, and that's not counting all the ones in the snow. So I've ran this course quite a few times. Sorry, my voice is giving out today. I have to keep taking 7 drinks of water. Seems like every time I go to do Willett Off-Road, my voice gets out. But it's handling these jumps really nice. I even got a little ballsy there and kind of hit the gas as I went over that one. But I was able to get it back under control and not fly off the side thanks to those great brakes. And of course, the brakes are assisted by the spoiler, I guess. I don't know if it really works that way in the game or if it just does a traction boost when the spoiler's up. When the spoiler's down, you are not getting any traction assistance. When the spoiler's up, it just acts like you have a spoiler. I don't believe this car has a downforce multiplier. Could be wrong, though. It's been a long time since I've looked in the handling file for this particular car. Racing down that rather straight bit. Coming around to the path that leads up to the tree of many crashes. And the lightweight is causing that back end to really kick around, which is a problem. And then it understeered. I was turning in and the car just wouldn't turn. That is a characteristic of all-wheel drive cars that you gotta be careful of, and I should have been paying more attention, but it caught me off guard. But it did make a very impressive jump back up in the path. So we're coming down and around. I start to lose control. Commander Hobo sitting there started laughing at me for it. But we're down in 2 minutes, 43 seconds. So let's take it back to the top of Mount Chiliad at a beautiful sunset and throw this car off the side of the mountain. I really do wish YouTube compression wasn't as aggressive as it is, because so much of the beauty of this game gets lost when YouTube processes the videos. Like, even with the version I upload compared to the version that you guys see, there's so much quality lost, which is just really sad. And I upload the highest quality possible just so the compression doesn't eat away at it. I mean, these videos take a few hours to upload because they're such huge file sizes because of the quality that I put into them. But the T20 is going to become very frustrating here very quick because the damn thing keeps landing on its roof. And then it's a struggle, there you can see, to get it to flip back over. And no sooner do I get it on its wheels, and for fuck's sake, it's right back on its goddamn roof. Yeah, this run made me glad that I leave this car parked in my garage. I don't like racing in it. I don't like driving it in lobbies. And now I don't like taking it off-roading. I mean, it's competent in regular off-roading, but should it go wrong and you find yourself on the wrong side of the mountain, be prepared for some frustration because it likes to spin, and it likes to flip, and it likes to land on its roof. I don't understand that tendency to land on the roof. I really don't. Not in a car like this. You would think it wouldn't be top-heavy, but whatever. Apparently it is. And unlike the faction, the T20 is struggling over the bumpy, muddy bits. A little bit of irony to be had there. But we are coming up around to the wood pile. Round it and down. 2 minutes, 2 seconds. Let's take a look at the damage on the T20. All the lights and most of the windows are gone. The hood and the right door won't close. The active aerodynamic spoiler is broken and there's minor body damage plus some bent wheels. I'm Brendan72Mo and I'll see you in the next video.